Hello friends, good morning to all of you. I am Professor Vinod Kumar Gupta. I retired from Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra, and worked abroad also in Fiji National University as professor. So today's topic is on a very innovative pedagogy, popularly known as WebQuest pedagogy. Generally, this pedagogy is not being followed in our universities, but it is gaining momentum these days. And because now everywhere this internet is being used and is linked with our learning. Either it is face-to-face, that is called as and blending learning, we are making use of the WebQuest pedagogy. The learning outcomes for today's topic, that is on WebQuest, the first one is that a simple definition I will be sharing with you. And second point, the levels, what are the levels of the WebQuest? And the third point I will be sharing, that is the database, finding database on WebQuest, rules for writing WebQuest, how to design a lesson plan on WebQuest, and if we want to upload on any database, then how can we upload a WebQuest on a particular database? And finally, I will be sharing what are the impacts of WebQuest on learning. So first of all, the definition part. The definition is can be taken up because it is we are to deal with the resources from the web. So it is an inquiry, web inquiry. We can attach with it, we can include with it other multimedia as well. And in this way, it is a internet-based inquiry, and with where we specify the data sources. So after the definition of WebQuest, now the level of WebQuest. There are two levels of WebQuest: short-term level and long-term level. Short-term and long-term means short-term only one, minimum one period or maximum three periods. So one period of 45 minutes, and similarly three periods can be used. For the long-term, you can use 1 week to 1 month. So that is long period. And in the short-term, our main goal is just to seek information from the various websites or the resources, internet resources, and then organize that. While in the long term, whatever we have organized, whatever we have searched, whatever knowledge we have acquired, that is to be further analyzed, that is to further synthesized, and then you are to create something new after involving your skills of analysis, synthesis, and evaluation. The information about the WebQuest databases can be taken up from various WebQuest databases, but the two most important websites or databases are, number one, webquest.org, and the second word is tommarch.com. These are the two databases where a lot of information is available about WebQuest. When we search webquest.org, then there is a provision where we can search many WebQuests. That is, Quest Garden database is given there, which has a number of WebQuests you can find out anyone, whatever you want to take up, and you can make inquiries on that. I have shown two screenshots. In one screenshot, I have shown about the Quest Garden database, and in the second screenshot, I have shown a web quest which is on research methodology. There are now I will be discussing on the rules of writing a web quest. There are five rules which are abbreviated as focus. F means you are to find the great sites, as I have pointed out, webquest.org or tommarsh.com. So you are to find the sites. And O for orchestrate learners and resources. It means that the learners and the resources, whatever we are providing to them, they are to be aligned properly so that all the learners may be engaged in the resources actively. And C stands for challenge your learners to think. It means for when they are engaged in the various resources, then they are to be motivated to think. You ought to put questions to them, and they are so that they may find answer, they may search, and in this way the thinking is to be challenged. That may be related to analysis, that may be related to synthesis, or that may be related to evaluation. U stands for use of media. Here the internet resources are being used, but suppose there are more than three students or five students, some of the students can be engaged in print media or some other media, and in this way everyone is to be engaged. So we can, along with the internet media, we can make use of other print media and other things are also, and that is to be planned in advance by the teacher. So you are to use multimedia. You are to make use of other media as well, along with internet resources. The lastly, the S. S stands for scaffolding. Scaffolding is nothing. It is just like a mother and child relationship, where the mother tries to assist the child to complete whatever the task has been given, suppose walking or doing something. Then the mother helps and provide all support. So similarly, the facilitator is to provide support to the learners in that type of relationship, mother-child relationship, at every stage. Now I will be taking up the designing part of a web quest lesson. There are six typical steps: the introduction, task, resources, and then process, evaluation, and conclusion. The first one is the introduction. In the introduction, you are to give the background so as to lead finally towards a particular question, and the inquiry should be on that question, and you ought to find out the answer to that question. So it is a problematic inquiry. And the second step is the resources, internet resources. another whatever is other print media can also be associated with it. Here the resources are not to be searched by the learner, but they are specified by the teacher. For example, we can mention webquest.org or tommarch.com, and the students can be asked to search the WebQuest examples given in the WebQuest garden, and they should be on the environment, for example. So they will be searching, or you can specify them that these are the WebQuest examples, and you are to find out all these six steps of WebQuest writing. You are to see the variation, what are the similarities, what are the differences, and in this way, in the resources, the things are very clearly mentioned which are they are to consult. The third point is the process point. In the process point, every step of the inquiry, how the inquiry is to be conducted, and suppose the students are to be divided into small groups, then the small group should be of three participants or four participants or five participants. It depends upon the earlier decision by the facilitator or the teacher. So, and the assignment is also clearly stated. What will be the role of first participant, second participant, third participant, like that, and how they will be interacting, how the inquiry is to be conducted, that is to dispatch. This is the process part. And after the process part, then it comes the evaluation. We provide them a evaluation guidelines in the form of a matrix, where the matrix can be called as rubric, and where we give the performance criteria. For example, what is the quality of the contents, or what was the level of their interaction with each other, and what was the level of analysis, synthesis, and creation, or quality of presentation. So these are the criteria, and what is the level of their achievement, that is also specified in the form of the grades, like it can be 1, 2, 3, or 4. So in this way, evaluation criteria is clearly mentioned, so that in advance, so they know what grade they will be getting. If they will perform at this level, they will get this grade. If they will perform at this level, they will get this way, this grade. In this way, very clearly, the guidelines, evaluation guidelines are mentioned, and this evaluation guidelines is also known as rubric. And the last point is the conclusion point, where you are to simply conclude, and you are to give your final analysis. What is your final creation? What are the implications? How it will be useful? And some idea or further investigations can also be given in that. So in this way, there are six steps in the inquiry, and they can be divided, as the whole 6 points can be completed in short-term lessons, or it can be long-term lessons. Now suppose you have completed your lesson on WebQuest on any topic of your choice, or whatever the topic has been assigned to you. You can upload that in the WebQuest database. In the screenshot, I have shown that how the WebQuest.org website has the provision for uploading a particular your prepared WebQuest lesson. Now I would like to share with you about the impact of WebQuest on learning. These WebQuest as an inquiry are very useful in developing higher order thinking skills. And second impact is that is on the development of collaborative attitudes. When the learners work in small groups, as I have mentioned while framing, that 3 or 4 or 5 students collectively are working, then and their roles are also assigned. They are to coordinate with each other. And in the process, when the project is before them, when the inquiry, WebQuest inquiry is before them, they have to collaborate. And they are combining together their experiences and synthesizing and collectively presenting before their peer groups. And in this way, they understand the importance and the value of teamwork or collaboration. Similarly, the third point is scaffolding learning. Scaffolding learning means as the facilitator deals with them, helps the learners at every moment in the beginning of the inquiry and the middle of the inquiry, at the end of inquiry, how to give it a shape in the template form. Or in the beginning, there can be a provision of a glossary or online directory or some other things, whatever the initial support is needed. And in the middle, during the inquiry, interactive process. So inputs, scaffolding, or process scaffolding, and the last is the output scaffolding. So in this way, scaffolding, three types of scaffolding can be provided, and the student when get the three types of scaffolding from the facilitator, they also understand how to scaffold. In this way, scaffolding process is also known to them, and they learn about scaffolding, how to deal with as a facilitator, as a teacher, and that is important. So in this way, these are the three most important impact. And the engagement, the fourth one is the engagement, active engagement of the learners in the activity given to the students. So these are the four important aspects, that is collaborative learning attitudes and higher order thinking skills, scaffolding learning, and active engagement of everyone. And this way the motivation also comes up. Number one is the definition. That is inquiry on the given resources from the internet along with other print media. Second point we have covered about levels, short-term WebQuest inquiry and long-term WebQuest inquiry. And then we came to know about what are the important websites on WebQuest inquiry, that is webquest.org and tommarch.com. And then I talked about the rules, 5 rules, abbreviated as FOCUS. F stands for finding the relevant sites or the websites or the databases or the resources. Second is the organization of learners and the resources, so that the learners and the resources properly, a learners may be engaged properly and the resources may be managed properly. So there must be proper alignment or organization of these two components. And third one, C is for that is challenging the thinking of the students, and U for use of the media resources, and the lastly S is for scaffolding part. So in this way, focus, these are the 5 rules. And then next steps come, that is how to design. That is introduction, then the task, then process, evaluation, and conclusion. We have concluded our topic on WebQuest pedagogy. I am highly thankful to you for listening patiently.